We've had a decidedly fruity feel to this series of The Garden Gurus, and today's no different. Except I want you to grow some near the house, and using pots is the perfect way to do it. Firstly, there's pretty much three types of dwarf fruit trees. And I don't mean three types of fruit, I mean three different types of dwarf fruit trees. There's varieties that are grafted onto dwarf rootstocks, which means you can still have your favourite type of fruit. For example, dwarf Washington navel oranges. Then there's those that are naturally dwarf, like the new Pinkerbell apple, which just grows as a compact tree. And then there are some like the dwarf citrus sublime, which grows on its own root system, and this keeps it compact and perfect for pots. Now, is one better than the other? Well, the answer is no. It just highlights how many different fruit you can grow in pots. If you love nectarines and peaches, then you want to keep your eye out for these guys. This is Nectarseed and Pixie, and they produce prodigious quantities of fruit in the summertime. And guess what? The fruit tastes just fantastic. Now, this one here is one that I think is very exciting. It's the first dwarf pear that I've seen. Now, it's a member of the Trixie range, but it's called Pipsqueak, and it's an absolute beauty. Now, this is a mini tree, just about 1.5 metres in height with a spread of about 1 metre in a pot like this. Produces lots of beautiful pears, and of course, pears are a superfruit, very high source of pectin and many of the antioxidants that we need in our system to keep us really healthy. So it makes a lot of sense to have at least one of these on your balcony. But how do you grow them in a pot? Well, first, get yourself a top quality potting mix. Always look for the red tick. It's a giveaway and it shows the Australian Standards Premium Certification. Ease your Trixie fruit tree into a pot that's half full of potting mix. Then you just top up around the outside and firm it down. Now, some people say it's not good to do this, but it's a load of rubbish because the plant has to be stable in the soil so it can establish its new roots quickly. If you really want to get your fruit trees off to a good start in pots, then you want to give them a good fertiliser. A liquid organic is the ideal way to go. You can't go past this stuff here. This is Searle's Fish and Kelp. Now, this fish emulsion is absolutely brilliant in stimulating new root growth. Now, you apply it every 2 weeks, so these plants will really establish quite quickly. Later on, you use a different type of fertiliser. The most important thing to remember with potted, fruiting or productive plants is that they use a lot of energy. So you need to boost them with an organic fertiliser that's designed to deliver performance plus. Now, kick-along fruit and flower is designed to maximise cropping. And the results, well, I've got to tell you, they're going to amaze you.